This session is being continued with the previous session where I have completed through complementation pathways, that is the classical pathway and alternative pathway, and now I lastly discuss about lectin pathway. Lectin pathway. Here the target cell definitely present and antibody is also present to form the target antibody, target cell antibody complex. Now here you see that in classical pathway the target antibody complex also forms here, but then C1 molecule came into action, but here no C1 molecule will come. Here instead of C1 molecule, here will come a protein molecule that is called lectin protein. This lectin protein being bound with a sugar called mannose. So it is called mannose binding lectin. Mannose binding lectin. So this mannose binding lectin along with other molecules, that is opsonin and phycolin, opsonin and phycolin, all these molecules, they activate enzymatic activity that is called mannose binding lectin associated serine protease activity. Mannose binding lectin associated serine protease activity. This activity then starts the function, the influence of this MBL, mannose binding lectin, along with the other molecules, that is opsonin and phycolin. You know what is opsonin? Opsonin is a protein molecule that forms a coat or coverings over any pathogen or microbe or bacterial cell, so that that opsonized pathogen or bacterial cell would be easily engulfed by a phagocytic cell, that is macrophage. And this process is called opsonization. So instead of C1, MBL is involved here. T, target cell antibody, plus MBL, they will act on this C4B. Then now the C4 molecule will come, and this MBL TAB acts on this C4 to break it into two fragments, C4B and C4A, and this C4B comes here to be associated with this MBL. So target antibody MBL C4B complex is formed. Now like the classical pathway, then come C2 molecule, and this C2A fragment becomes associated to C2A, becomes associated to this complex to form target cell antibody MBL C4B C2A complex. One thing is important here, that is In the classical pathway, the C3 molecules are involved, C3 molecules, but here no C3 molecule will come. No C3 molecule will come here. This C4BC2A along with MBL having the C5 convertase enzymatic activity. C5 convertase enzyme activity. So here you see that C1, C4B, C2A, and that is C3B. This complex having the C5 convertase, but here no C1 is present. Instead of C1, MBL is present. MBL, C4B, C2A. No C3B is present here. So these three components together constitute a complex having the C5 convertase activity. So by the action of this convertase activity, this C5 splits into C5B and C5A, like the classical pathway. And this C5B again binds to this C5B and binds to this complex, so to form T target cell antibody MBL C4B C2A C5B complex. Then just like the classical pathway or other complementation process, sequentially becomes attached of C6, C7, C8, C9. Sequentially, the C6, C7, C8, C9 complements molecule will come here to be attached to this complex to form ultimately a complicated complex, that is target cell antibody MBL C4B C2A C5B C6 C7 C8 C9. But here is also, you look this, that C5B C6 C7 C8 C9, this is membrane attack complex. This membrane attack complex attacks the membrane of this target cell or pathogen or microbe and destroys it. Since in this pathway the mannose binding lectin present, that is this pathway is mediated by mannose binding lectin, so this pathway is called lectin pathway. So I discussed about the three different pathways. One is classical pathway, antibody mediated. Second one is alternative pathway. No antibody is present here, only microbe alone present here. And then lectin pathway, mediated by mannose binding lectin. Now, during this complementation process, now you see that the each complementation process is occurred by some sequential steps, like the orchestra, through the sequential steps in a synchronized sequential fashion or manner. So they are interdependent. So this process is called complementation. This complementation process is again regulated by some regulatory proteins. As for example, factor I, it inhibits or inactivates some complement molecules. Again, DAF, another regulatory protein or factor, and also maybe CD59 cluster differentiation, that is the glycoprotein. CD. All the complement molecules also like glycoprotein in nature and protein in nature. And this regulatory protein, they are protein and also CD59. It is protein, rather glycoprotein. So CD59 also regulates this complementation process. Lastly, I say that what is the significance of this complementation process? What is the significance? Significance. The first one is inflammation. I already discussed that the smaller fragments are diffused away from the site of action and they go to the local receptor, bind to them and initiates inflammation. This inflammation directly activates mast cell. Then mast cell releases histamine, and this histamine encounters the microbe or antigen or pathogen. Next is phagocytosis. You know that in the leptin mediated pathway, the opsonization occurs there. And by this process of opsonization, the microbe or pathogen or antigen becomes covered with the opsonin. And it welcomes the phagocytic cell or tissue macrophage, so that then macrophage will come to that opsonized microbes or pathogen. That is, this microbes or pathogen becomes phagocytosed or engulfed by that tissue macrophage by the process of phagocytosis. So phagocytosis. Another one is lysis. You know lysis. Lysis is done by membrane attack complex. In every pathways of complementation, lastly the membrane attack complex, C5B, C6, C7, C8, C9 membrane attack complex, lastly attacks the membrane of the microbes or pathogen and destroys or ruptures its membrane. So again, this complementation process facilitates the antigen clumping process so that the defense mechanism can be facilitated. So complementation process is a facilitatory process of the defense mechanism by the host against the pathogen or microbe. So this is all about complementation process. I hope this is now clear to all of you. Thank you.